So I'm here with Kenneth Otalor today. Can you tell us the name of your company and where you're based?
Yeah, thank you very much for having me. Calero Technologies. We are, as the whole blockchain is decentralized, as a company, we're also quite decentralized. So we've got a main head office in Vienna, Austria, but also we're setting up an office in Seoul, Korea, and then also in Africa. So we'll be in Kenya and also in Latin America, Peru.
Quite global. So what is your interest in being in Malta today? Why are you at the summit?
Thank you. This is actually my third time in Malta. Phenomenal place. Some people say it's an island, some people say it's a country. I'm not too sure which one it is at the moment. But ultimately, it reminds me so much of a location whereby you can really enjoy the quality of life. The standard of living is quite high. But ultimately, it has that kind of like holiday buzz to it, but you can also do business. So it's just a phenomenal environment, atmosphere, where you can be happy while also working.
So you mentioned earlier that your company is interested in blockchain subject matter.
Yes.
Can you let me know what your thoughts are on the regulatory framework for blockchain in Malta?
Yeah, so basically I think the reason why Malta has become really the epicenter of blockchain is because the government has really been pro-blockchain. They've really taken initiatives to be able to support blockchain startups, businesses that really want to scale when other countries have been way behind the curve. Hence the reason why they're now really so far ahead. And I think as the whole market matures, Malta will still become really the main place where people want to do business.
But blockchain technology is still quite new to most people. So what do you think are two challenges that companies involved in blockchain face, and how do you think Malta can make itself a more attractive environment?
One of the challenges is also the regulation aspect. I think if you're going to be doing things that involve transactions in terms of money, holding client funds, especially from the, let's just say, the management, asset management aspect that you want to use, like tokenized security tokens, really having the license to have that is really essential to make sure that the application process is efficient and streamlined is somewhat a challenge, but it's an area that if Malta can really control and take advantage of this, they can really be an attractive place for people in that specific fintech industry that they can be able to come. The second aspect I would say is really the appeal. Obviously Malta, prior to Malta being part of the EU, has really been known for the opportunity for people to come for tax reasons, yes. However, there's still this kind of like this taste in the mouth when people think about this. So I think really moving away from that and saying, listen, yes, you can have corporation tax, which is quite low. However, the quality of life, the other aspects, healthcare, transportation, that can really be also be part of the reason why people want to be able to move. So these are some of the areas they need to look at.
And lastly, what have you enjoyed the most out of the summit so far?
For me, I'm a true believer in if you have a product or if you have an idea that you want to now turn into a product, and then you want to then start offering this to customers or start raising capital, so you cover the whole supply chain, let's just say, you need to be in be part of a community or in a location where you can connect. Being here today or being part of this summit really provides the opportunity where you can network, you can meet people, and you can really grow your business.
Great. Thank you very much for your time.
You're welcome.